When we go into detail and see the composition of this 1991 patient, we could say that 46 patients had a distant metastasis during the follow-up period, and 54 didn't have, they were free of metastasis. And if we go further, we could say that 33 patients had a metastasis limited to bone, 10 had metastasis in other organs, and 3 patients had secondary tumor. So if we go that way, we could say 32 patients had adenocarcinoma, one in anaplastic adenocarcinoma, and we can make two groups from these 32. 20 patients had bone metastasis within 1 year after the DDV treatment, and 12 patients received bone metastasis later than 1 year. So we could say this 20 patient is a homogeneous, and this 12 was a homogeneous population. So we checked the median survival time of the 20 patient, and in that case, we could get a 64.8 months median survival time. If we compare it with a historical control, what we can see in the literature, it should be about 15, 20 months. So we could say that there was a big increase in the median survival time in that small group of patients. And just an example of why we can get increase, we, why we could increase the median survival time. So here is one example with a patient who had a PSA level over 1,000, 1,000 in 2002. And of course, he received conventional therapy and hormone therapy, and there was a decrease in the PSA level, and he started to consume water. That means the the DDW consumption, and this is the PSA level. And in the last 8 years, we could keep the PSA level low and no any complaint, and he's fine. Another patient, he started 5 years ago with over a 500 PSA, and it went down, and you could see the cause-effect relationship. When he stopped drinking DDW, the PSA went up. He started to consume again, the PSA goes down. He stopped again, up. He started again, we could stop again the PSA level. He stopped consuming water last year in January, and he's planning to start again to consume lutein-depleted water. So that would be a couple of example that why should we, why could we keep the people alive in a bone metastasis? So if you go to that group with 12 patients and the metastasis appeared 1 year later that they started to consume DDW, we in the cumulative follow-up period is 103 years, and 2 patients died out of 12, so we were not able to calculate the median survival time. So maybe 10 years later, we can calculate the median survival time of this population. And this is an example. So there was a prostatectomy in that case, in that patient, but the PSA level was still high, and it was very probably that some metastasis is present. And that person very regularly repeat the cure. 6 years after that, his PSA is low and he's tumor-free. And here's another example. He just died. He lived in Austria, and he had a prostatectomy 13 years ago. He started to consume lutein-depleted water 11 years ago, and he consumed for a very long period of time. Then there was a break, and then start again. And for very long, there was a long break here. There was an increase in PSA level. At that time, he started to consume again. We could stop the PSA, but after that, we couldn't stop the PSA increase. And I just received a letter from his wife that he had passed, unfortunately. Okay, if we go back to the other population, these 45 patients who were tumor-free and metastasis-free, here is a median survival time. So in that case, the cumulative follow-up is 157 years, and 4 patients died out of 45, and again, we were not able to calculate the median survival time. And we think that we can prevent the metastasis because these people regularly consume lutein-depleted water. Okay, conclusion. So the phase 2 double-blind clinical trial indicated the anti-cancer effect of lutein depletion, because PSA level decreased, prostate volume decreased, urination problem were ceased, and the death rate and the survival were decreased, and the survival time increased. We say that the prospective study showed a 2-3-fold increase in the median survival time. And we could say that the administration of DDW increased the life expectancy of patients having bone metastasis. And we also can say that consumption of DDW delay or prevent the appearance of distant metastasis. Thank you for your attention.
Any comments, questions?
Actually, I've got a couple of questions from the first part of your study, of your clinical study, the prospective bit. I remember, I'm not sure whether I may have missed this, but you have your clinical outcome that you measured was the size of the prostate and the urination, wasn't it?
The primary endpoint was the how can we increase,
yes,
and what will be the reaction, partial response and complete response and no change.
Yes.
And the primary endpoint was whether we can increase the ratio or complete response or partial response, mm, significantly between the two arms.
That's right.
And to decide whether it's partial response or complete response, we followed a couple of parameters of the patient.
All right. I was wondering whether, have you looked at the level of PSA?
Yeah, this is what I mentioned, that in 15 cases there was over 50% decrease in the PSA level.
And also, did you have some sort of exclusion and inclusion criteria? Couldn't we say exclude the 4 patients in placebo arm with adenocarcinoma?
We didn't exclude them. We simply recognized that unfortunately there was some heterogeneity between the two arms, and that maybe helped or ruined the efficacy in the placebo arm.
So what were then the exact inclusion and exclusion criteria for your patients?
The exclusion criteria was the body weight. Over 100 kilogram, we excluded the patient, and in a terminal phase, and we talk about, I think, 6 months life expectancy. Otherwise, I know today I would plan a different clinical trial, and maybe we should have focus on 1 or 2 stages, for example, of the patient that would help us. But at that time, my idea was that we will see the effect. I think we saw the effect. And that was the reason that, for example, people from different stages were involved in the trial.
Okay. Some other questions? Thank you very much, Dr. Chamoy.